We have 11.2 transforming the graph of a natural exponential function. So we do need to pay attention to our transformations this time and all of them, okay? So we already know, like, if you have a function and you have its basic, you have a base, the x, and that's it, right? Okay, if you put a negative out here, so there's a, there, okay, I'll just go over all the different transformations. So if you put a negative out there, what it's gonna do is it's gonna reflect over the x-axis. If you put the negative here, it's gonna reflect over the y-axis. Meaning this part's gonna come over here, that part's over there. Reflection over the x-axis means all of the top reflects downward toward the bottom. You use this button to reflect over the x-axis. You use this button to reflect over the y-axis, okay? And then we also know that we have shifts. So if you have x plus a number, it's gonna go left. If you have x minus a number, you know it's going to go right. If you have plus a number on the outside, it's going to go up. And if you have minus a number on the outside, it's going to go down. And for all four of these transformations, you use this icon and you just literally grab it and move it around. So do your reflections first, whether you have one or the other or both of them. Click on your reflections first and then grab the whole parabola and move it around. And when you grab it and move it around, it's always going to grab it from this point, and that's what's going to be moving around. Okay, so for me, the first thing that I would do is I would notice that I have a negative in there, which means I'm going to have a reflection over the y-axis, which means I'm going to click on this button in Alex. And Alex will do it for you, but it will reflect this over the y-axis for you. Okay, so it'll do that for you. Then what you want to do is you want to take this transformation, which means I need to be going up 6 units, and grab this and move it up 6 units. So 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now the plot point is way up there, and then going up and then going downward. Okay. And so it will move everything for you. You just have to click on the correct buttons to flip it over and then drag it as far and in which direction you're supposed to drag it. Okay, so for this one, if I take the basic graph that was given to me, which was e to the x, it looks like this. Okay, then I notice that there's a negative in the front. Because there's a negative in the front, that means it's going to flip it over the x-axis, which means I need to click on this button. When I do that, it's gonna automatically draw the reflection for me. I'm not gonna have to worry about that, whether or not it's drawn properly, because it'll do it for me. But then because of the +4 on the inside, up in the exponent, that means I'm actually gonna go to the left 4. So after I've reflected it, I'm gonna grab it. I'm gonna grab, click on this icon with the little arrows. And then from there, it's gonna let me grab the dot where it is right now and then move it around. And so I would have to move it over 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it would draw the graph over there. Okay, again, you wouldn't have to worry about, you know, whether it fits on the graph or whether, all you have to do is reflect it and then drag and drop to the location that it needs to be at.